Hello friends, this is a solution video for question number 3, chapter 2, H C Verma, physics class 11th. So the question says, add vectors A, B and C, each having magnitude of 100 unit and inclined to the x-axis at angles 45 degree, 135 degree and 315 degree respectively. So I have drawn these three vectors, vector A which is inclined 45 degree, vector B which is inclined 135 degree and vector C which is inclined 315 degree with the x-axis. So we have to find the addition of these three vectors. So I have to get vector A plus vector B plus vector C. So in this particular problem, to add any two vector or three vector or multiple vector, we can easily add vectors in their component form, right? So we can resolve all these individual vector in their x component and y component respectively, and then we can simply add them and we can find the answer, right? So first of all, resolution of vector in the two component, one is x-axis and with the y-axis. So I can write x component of vector A is 100 cos 45 degree, y component of vector A is going to be 100 sin 45 degree, and in their component form I can write this vector A as 100 cos 45 degree is 1 by root 2, 100 by root 2 I plus 100 sin 45 degrees root 2 j. So I have converted this vector A in its component form, which is 100 by root 2 I plus 100 by root 2 j. Similarly, we can find the x component of B, y component of B, then further x component of C and y component of C. So let us try to find out x component of vector B is 100 cos 135 degree, y component of vector B is 100 sine 135 degree. So now this 135, so this can be written as 100 cos of 90 plus 45 degree, this can be written as 100 sine 90 plus 45 degree, right? And cos 90 plus 45 degree means it will come in the second quadrant, and cos is negative in second quadrant, so the I component of B vector can be written as negative 100, and now it will become sine 45 degree. So the entire thing will become sine 45 degree I plus, now 100 sine 90 plus theta is in second quadrant, sine in second quadrant is positive, so this will become now cos 45 degree, right? So this will become minus 100 by root 2 I plus 100 by root 2 j. Further, we'll find the x component for C and y component for C. So x component of C vector is 100 cos of 315 degree and y component of C vector is 100 sine 315 degree. Again, this cos 315 degree can be written as cos of 360 degree minus 45 degree. Similarly, it can be written as sine 360 degree minus 45 degree. We know that cos in fourth quadrant is positive, but sine in fourth quadrant is negative. So the vector C will become 100 cos of 45 degree minus 100 sine of 45 degree. So in this case, the trigonometry function will not change. So this C vector will become 100 by root 2 I minus 100 by root 2 J. So we have converted all these three vectors in their component form, and now I can easily add them as vector A plus vector B plus vector C is 100 upon root 2 I plus 100 upon root 2 J. This is for A vector, plus minus 100 by root 2 I plus 100 by root 2 J. This is for vector B, and 100 by root 2 I minus 100 by root 2 J. This is for C vector. Now I can simply see this minus 100 by root 2 I can be cancelled out with this one, and 100 by root 2 J can be cancelled out with this one. So the addition of these three vectors, is there is 100 by root 2 I plus 100 by root 2 J. And now if I want to calculate the magnitude of this vector, so let us say this vector is R, which is A plus B plus C. So this R vector is 100 by root 2 I plus 100 by root 2 J. And if I want to calculate the magnitude of this vector, so this will become under the root 100 by root 2 square plus 100 by root 2 square, right? So this is coefficient of I square plus coefficient of J square under the root. So this will become 100 square by 2 plus 100 square by 2. So finally it will become, resultant of this R vector is 100 units. And now if I want to calculate the angle of this resultant, so that can be easily determined by, so if this is the R vector, which is xi plus yj, so the angle of this resultant with the x-axis is given by tan theta is y component upon x component. So in this particular case, where the resultant is 100 by root 2 I plus 100 by root 2 J, so this tan theta will become, the y is 100 by root 2 and x component is 100 by root 2. So this will become, theta is tan inverse 1, that means theta is 45 degree. So the resultant is 100 units in magnitude and making an angle theta with the x-axis. Thank you for watching this video. Please subscribe my channel for more solution video from H C Verma. And if you have any doubt or any problem of physics and mathematics, then write problem in comment box and I will provide the solution for that problem. Thank you.